Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous videos, you looked at round-tripping 3D models between Autodesk Flame and Autodesk Maya. This is a great set of videos, and I urge you to watch them if you're constantly moving between applications. But in the initial setup, the 3D objects were textured using Substance PBR materials in Flame. In this video, you'll create the PBR texture in Maya and load it into Flame as part of the FBX import. This workflow is supported using Maya 2018.1 and the Flame 2018.3 update. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast version of this video, then please type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. Starting in Maya 2018.1, create a new Maya scene. Now you could be in the process of creating a new 3D model or importing one. For this example, you'll start with the latter. Click the File menu and choose Import. Ensure the file type is set to FBX and locate the downloaded media. Select the FBX file and click Import. The model is quite large as it appears in the 3D scene, so press F to frame the 3D object to the viewport. Now here you have a hollow ball that is textured with the default Maya material. If you select the object and look at its material properties, you can see that it is using the standard Lambert shader. Now before you apply the PBR material to this object, you need to set the viewport correctly as well as ensure that the material shader is loaded into the application. In the viewport, enable the textured and lighting buttons. The model goes black because lighting has been enabled in the scene, but there are currently no lights. This will be resolved shortly as you add the PBS materials. Now let's ensure that the specific shader is loaded into the Maya framework. Go to the Windows menu, Settings and Preferences, and choose Plugin Manager. This window contains all the modules that could be loaded into the Maya application. To quickly find the specific module, click the search box and type Shader Effects. This will filter the list and locate the Shader Effects plugin bundle. Ensure both options are ticked so that the plugin is loaded into Maya. Now the reason why this is important is if you click on the Information button, you will get a list of dependencies for the plugin. One of them is the Stingray PBS, which is the material that you will use. Now close both windows. To apply the Stingray PBS texture to the model, call up the contextual menu over the 3D object. Towards the bottom of the list, choose Assign New Material. This brings up a new window, and you will find the Stingray PBS material. As a reminder, if the Shader Effects plugin was not enabled, the Stingray PBS material would not appear in this list. Choose the material, and it is applied to the hollow ball. Now, the Stingray PBS material is part of a set of tools known as Shader Effects, hence the Shader Effects button. But more importantly, all the standard values match what you have in Flame. So there is the base color, metallic, roughness, and emissive. Flame actually has a few more PBR options, but most should be available here. To illustrate the point, move the base color closer to white, give the metallic a high value, and the roughness a low value. Now deselect the object to see the texture properly. So this material is now very shiny and reflective. You can adjust these values to mimic most material types around. I'd also like to point out that when you applied the Stingray PBS material, this automatically activated the image-based lighting or IBL in the 3D scene. The IBL map that is used by default is called the Stingray Skydome. You have the same IBL available in Flame, which should allow you to match the same lighting later on. You could change the IBL, but just ensure you have the same one available for Flame for the lighting to match. Now select the hollow ball again. In addition to setting the specific values on the Stingray PBS material, you could also use OpenEXR images as part of the PBR texture. So enable Color Map, Normal Map, Metallic Map, Roughness Map, and finally the Ambient Occlusion Map. The shader is now expecting texture inputs. Scroll to the Textures section and start loading the supplied texture maps. I'll do the first example, and then you can repeat the same steps for each of the supplied maps. Click the Color Map button, and you'll be taken into the file panel. Click the folder next to the image name. In the browser, navigate to the downloaded OpenEXRs. Choose the Base Color 1 EXR file, and click Open, and the file is loaded into the panel. If you are working in a color managed pipeline, don't forget to set the appropriate color space. In this case, set the color space to Scene-linear Rec709 sRGB. Finally, click the Show Output Connection to go back to the Stingray PBS menu. Repeat the same steps for the Normal, Metallic, Roughness, and AO map. So after applying the different maps, here is the result of the Stingray PBS shader. Now here are some more important points to keep in mind. If you click the Open Shader Effects button, this launches the Shader Effects Node Editor. The Stingray PBS material is built using the Shader Effects Node Graph. What is important here is that the Flame 2018.3 update only supports the default node flow graph. If you were to alter the graph or add more nodes, you might get unexpected results when importing this into Flame. Secondly, the other reason for coming into this graph is if you are using a color managed pipeline, ensure you find the color map node and change the encoding to the matching color space. So switch from sRGB map to linear color. Now close the Shader Effects menu. Since you're in a 3D application, let's do a small tweak to the UVs on the 3D object to adjust the texture. Ensure the object is selected and click the UV menu. Choose UV Editor. To display the texture, click the Texture menu and choose the Roughness map. You could use any one of them, but I found this to be pretty clear. To adjust the model's UVs to the texture, call up the contextual menu over the selected object and choose UV Shell. Select the UVs and switch to the Scale mode. Scale the UVs from the center and the texture will adjust itself on the model. Once you're happy, close the UV editor and switch back to the object mode through the contextual menu. When you orbit the view, you can see how the texture wraps around the model and is using the physical-based rendering in conjunction with image-based lighting. Now let's move this into Flame to see what you get. Select the hollow ball and click the File menu. Choose Export Selection. Ensure the file type is set to FBX and give it an appropriate name. The FBX version is set to 2018 and please click Export Selection. Coming over into Flame, you're starting in a fresh batch group and drag out a new action node from the batch node bin. Double-click on the node for its controls, and switch to a 2-up view with Alt 2. Action schematic to the left, and result viewport to the right. Before importing the 3D model and the PBR texture, remember that I said that IBLs are not supported with the FBX interchange format. So let's set this up in Flame. Select the camera and call up the contextual menu. Choose Add Node and select IBL. The IBL node is connected to the camera, and this needs to be changed to match the IBL that was used in Maya. Double-click on the IBL for its controls, and choose the Read File menu. Click the Load button to launch the file browser. The default IBL map that Maya uses with the Stingray PBS texture is the Stingray SkyDome EXR. This is bundled with Flame. Select the EXR and press Load. So that should take care of the lighting. Now let's import the 3D model. Call up the contextual menu and choose Import. In the browser, navigate to the exported FBX file. Select the FBX and ensure AutoFit in Scene is off. Load the FBX geometry into action, and looking at the model in the result view, the textures should match what you had in Maya. This also includes any of the UV adjustments made before the export. And if you look at the action schematic, you can see the geometry node and all the associated EXR textures that were mapped in Maya using the Stingray PBS material. If you were to select the shader node and look at the roughness and metallic values, you will find that these give the same results that were set in Maya. So that is how you can create your own PBS materials in Maya and carry them over into Flame using the FBX interchange format. Don't forget to also check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.